What's up, Tailgaters? My name is Tailgate Nate, and welcome to my channel. MAC predictions are done, which means we have 9 conferences plus the independents done. So over this weekend, I'll be doing Conference USA, but we will talk about that in a little bit. The Mid-American Conference has every single team up now. You can go watch a video. This is a standings recap, standings predictions. You see your lovely standings board over here. The MAC, one of the few conferences in college football that still have divisions. Well, they're actually about half and half right now, but you got the MAC East on the east or right-hand side. You got the MAC West on the west or left-hand side, and we're going to talk about why each team is placed where they are, why I kind of gave each team the record that they have, and we'll kind of go through, give a tiny preview of the Mid-American Conference Championship game. But thank you guys so much for the love, support, and the growth of the channel this summer. We've passed 1,200 subscribers. If we can get it to like 1,270 or something like that, I think we've have 500 new subscribers joined this year, which is just, joined this summer, which is crazy. Continue to show support for the channel by subscribing, ringing the bell. I post videos during the season, but again, there are more ways to help me support my channel. You're doing one way right now by watching the video, and you can do more by liking, commenting, sharing, and anything else that you guys are willing and able to do. Seriously, it means a lot to me. Thank you guys so, so much. Let's break down the Mid-American Conference. All right, we're going to start out with the MAC West. So we're going to go over to the far left, far left-hand side of the screen, and then we're going to move our way back. So we're going to start with Central Michigan, end with the Ohio Bobcats, and take a little preview of the Mid-American Conference Champions game. So the Central Michigan Chippewas are sitting down there at 2-10, 1-7 in conference. I do have them as the last place team in the MAC West this season, and the quite simple reason for that this year is that Central Michigan lost a ton offensively. Quarterback, running back, even some good pieces at the wide receiver position are gone this year. Defensively now, that is definitely going to be a bright side for the Central Michigan Chippewas. I think it's going to keep a lot of games competitive for them, and who knows, the defense may be able to steal some wins. But offensively, I don't have a lot of confidence in this Chippewa team, and I think it'll lead them to be the bottom team on this side of the Mid-American Conference standings. Let's move it over to the Ball State Cardinals. Again, this is a team that does lose a ton of production. Offensively, defensively, while there are a couple positions that do return a lot of talent, I believe secondary is one where you do return quite a few really key pieces from last season, but you lose Carson Steele at running back. There are there's going to be a change at the quarterback position this year. There's a lot of change with Ball State, and it definitely feels like a team that's going to be very, very thin. That, again, if it ends up getting down to their second or third strings, that could be a team that is in real trouble. But, again, I do think there are enough pieces there to help them pull out a couple of games in conference play, so they're sitting there at 3-9. In conference, the fifth place team. The fourth place team is Western Michigan, now 3-9, maybe on the lower end of what Western Michigan is capable of, because again, there is a lot of talent leaving that team as well. You got some really solid pieces in the skill position group, a ton, including two really good pieces, leave off of that defensive line. However, I am a believer in what Western Michigan has there talent-wise, and I know it may not show in my record prediction for them this season. Western Michigan, I think, is going to be very competitive, keep a lot of games very, very close, but again, they may not have that second level or that next level talent to be able to pull out wins in the close game scenarios. Again, I could be wrong on that. I fully recognize that that is a possibility. Western Michigan, I have being competitive, just not leading to many wins for them here in 2023. Let's move on to the top half of the MAC West. When we talk about the Eastern Michigan Eagles, this is going to be a great team here in 2023. It starts with Samson Evans at running back. He's one of, if not the best running back in the entire Mid-American Conference, and he is going to have opposing defenses shaking because he is just that good of a player. Very shifty, very fast. He's a very, very good player. I'd be scared to go up against him if I were anyone on Eastern Michigan's Mid-American Conference schedule, or anyone on their schedule, really, period. I think they play Minnesota in a non-conference game, and they lost a lot of physicality, so we'll see what that defense is made of in trying to stop Samson Evans. But when I take a look at this Eastern Michigan team, a lot of solid pieces on defense, and besides Samson Evans, you got some good offensive talent as well. Who knows? This could be a team ready to explode in the Mid-American Conference this year. Watch for it. Right now, I got them sitting at third. They very well could be second, and you could flip Northern Illinois down the third, but due to their conference record, the Huskies, for me, are sitting at second in the conference. It is a very favorable cross-divisional schedule, if I'm remembering correctly, but Northern Illinois, They were not very good last year, at least record-wise they weren't, but there are a lot of factors for that reason. Northern Illinois is dealing with some injuries and consistency issues last year. Rocky Lombardi should be the full-time starter if he can stay healthy. Knock on wood. Hope I didn't jinx anything there. His favorite target in 2023 should be Tavon Rudolph, who is coming back after missing all of last season. You still got a really good stable of running backs. Defensively, a lot of pieces come back. Northern Illinois, there's no reason in my mind why the Huskies are not a much improved team in 2023. And I think it's going to show with them finishing second in this division again due to that conference record. But by far and away, without a shadow of a doubt, the Toledo Rockets are the best team. Maybe in this entire conference, but bona fide, they are the best team in this division. Toledo returns Daquan Finn at quarterback, and I could list off as many weapons as I'd like on that offensive end that Toledo has coming back this year. Really good running back room with one of the best 1-2 punches that the group of five is going to see this season. Really good stable of wide receivers. The defense returns a ton of talent as well. There's going to be very few teams in the Mid-American Conference that are good enough to beat Toledo. And there are even fewer teams, or I should say there are few teams that are going to be able to slow down Toledo, and there are even fewer teams that are going to be able to beat them even if they can slow them down. So the Toledo's just going to be very dynamic this year. They'll sit at the top of the MAC West, in my opinion. Let's go to the MAC East here, talk about the two bottom teams in this division, and it starts with the Kent State Golden Flashes, and I gotta be honest, I'm just not confident what the Golden Flashes have this year. Everyone and their mother has transferred out of that program, especially on the offensive end. Collin Schley, Marquez Cooper, two really, really good wide receivers, and much more on the offensive end. Now, defense, hey, there are a couple nice returning pieces there, but you have basically an entirely new roster with a couple of big returning pieces, and a new head coach is coming in there. It's just a lot of change happening at once for Kent State, and I think that team is really going to struggle this season. I got them last in the Mid-American Conference and last in the division, and of course last in the conference as well. Akron is here second to last in the division with the Akron Zips. 2-10, I think, is on the lower end of what this team is capable of. Again, I like DJ Irons' play at the quarterback position. I think he can be pretty dang good. And again, if everything goes well and this offensive line can improve, we might be looking at a 3,000-yard season for DJ Irons. But there are some really talented transfers coming into that program offensively, defensively. And I think Joe Moorhead is going about this the right way. I think he has the right attitude towards Akron. I think he's the right man for the job. It may be a couple more years before we start to see some big results from this Akron team. But I think, again, if they can make the necessary improvements this year, the pieces are in place for Akron to make a big jump. That is my opinion on that team, at least. Bowling Green is here. Now, I do have them missing a bowl game just because their non-conference schedule has some very tough games. Bowling Green can just as easily make a bowl game last season. They made a bowl game at 6-6 while leaving some wins on the table. However, there are some factors to why I have them I predict them the way that I have. While there is some really good returning talent and a key transfer coming in at quarterback, Connor Bazelak has proven when he's at his best, he is a Power 5 level quarterback. The only problem, Bowling Green's offensive and defensive numbers have to take a big jump. And again, in order for that to happen, there have to be some guys that really step up and play a lot bigger roles than what they did last season. Bowling Green's going to be a competitive team in conference, and that's going to be a really tough team to beat. Again, that they could get that extra conference win to boost them to bowl game. Who knows, maybe they beat Liberty or someone else in non-conference towards the beginning of the season. Bowling Green is not a pushover team by any means, but just due to that non-conference schedule, I have them just shy of a bowl game here in 2023. So let's talk about the three teams that will make a bowl game, in my opinion. Miami of Ohio is here. Now, wide receiver is the biggest question mark on this team. With Mac Hippenhammer and a lot of other weapons gone, it leaves the wide receiver room feeling pretty thin. There's a lot of unknown in that wide receiver room, at least a lot of unproven according to the stat sheets from previous seasons. However, Brett Gabbert is coming back at quarterback. Did miss a lot of last season with injury, and if he can stay healthy again, knock on wood, this is going to be one of the better teams in the Mid-American Conference this season. I shouldn't say much improved team, but definitely an improved team from last season. There are a lot of good defensive pieces here, but Brett Gabbert is good enough. He's got a good enough arm and a good enough ability to really drive this team and pull out some wins. Miami, Ohio is going to be a really good team this year. I got them sitting at 8-4, 6-2 in conference. Same record as the team ahead of them, the Buffalo Bulls. Buffalo is going to be one of the best teams in the Mid-American Conference again this season. Definitely a contender for a Mid-American Conference title bid. There are a lot of great skill position players returning for that offense. You got a returning quarterback, but the defense for this Bulls team, while it does lose a lot of names off of that defense, oh boy, is this still going to be a really, really good unit in 2023. Buffalo is going to be really, really good. That's a team that, again, I think is going to sit towards the top of the Mid-American Conference. It starts with the defense, but don't discount that that offense either. Buffalo had a pretty surprising year last season. Who knows? Maybe that's a team that makes the Mid-American Conference Championship this year. But again, I don't think so. I knew the two teams that are going to make the Mid-American Conference Championship, at least in my mind. Toledo, you saw it at the other division. And at top of this, and at the top of this division are the Ohio Bobcats. The Bobcats are a team that I think is going to, maybe besides the Toledo Rockets, their cross-divisional counterpart, I think Ohio is going to have the best is going to have the best offense in the conference this year. Again, of course, besides the Toledo Rockets, but I just said that, didn't I? Ohio is just returning so much. Curtis Rourke, O'Shawn Allison, a lot of pieces in the wide receiver room, and the defense should still be really solid as it was last season. Ohio, I have is undefeated in conference play. Wouldn't surprise me if maybe there is a 7-1 in the parentheses at the end of the season. But the two teams that I have making the Mid-American Conference Championship game, and it's not even close in my mind, is Toledo and Ohio. There's just too much returning talent on both of those rosters, I think, for them to not finish at the top of their respective divisions. They're power ranked 1-2 for me in this conference. I really, really like both of these teams this year, and this is going to be a very competitive, very interesting Mid-American Conference Championship, a rematch from last season, Daquan Finn versus Curtis Rourke, two really good offensive teams with a lot of solid returning talent on defense. If you are someone that really doesn't watch Group of Five conferences and maybe just tuned in to see what the MAC may look like this year, this is going to be a must-watch game. Toledo and Ohio will be very fun this year. They don't play it in the regular season, so getting it in a Mid-American Conference Championship game, I think, is going to be something special. But hey, look at us. MAC predictions are done. One more conference left. It's Conference USA. So over the next 3 to 4 days, we'll be talking about the 9 teams in Conference USA, including a couple of new teams to the FBS level. That does it for me here, guys. Remember to play hard, but tailgate harder. Continue to show support for the channel, and I'll see all you guys tomorrow when we start Conference USA. Goodbye.